everyone, this is Richard.
And this is Linda.
Welcome to the Day Zero Gamer Infinite Live Show, the show number 75 for April 21st, 2013. Well, howdy, Linda. How you doing?
Yo. I'm doing great. You?
Pretty good. Pretty darn good. So let's get this train moving. So what is coming out for this next week?
Today, April 21st, LEGO City Undercover The Chase Begins comes out for the 3DS. Then Tuesday, April 23rd, Dead Island Riptide comes out for the 360 and PS3. Dragon's Dogma Dark Arisen comes out for the 360 and PS3. And Star Trek comes out for the 360 and PS3. And that's all I have to report for this week.
Alrighty. So Injustice Gods Among Us came out. So I've been rocking that. Pretty darn good so far. Apart from that, I actually went back and started playing a little bit of Soul Calibur 5 for some reason. So I'm juggling two fighting games again. and I finished the week rocking some Halo 4. So that was fun.
Sweet.
How about you?
I played a bunch of Black Ops 2.
Oh, nice.
Yep. Really enjoyed it. Just loving the new maps. I have to say, I absolutely love Studio.
Okay.
Studio
so what's,
is...
Yeah, what's that about?
Training Grounds.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Huh.
I love Training Grounds. So when I saw Studio come up, I didn't think anything of it. I'm like, oh, that's weird. You're going to be, you know, I'm thinking a studio lot with lots of weird backgrounds or whatever.
Oh, yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
But then I spawned and I'm like, oh my gosh, this is like a better version of Training Grounds.
Wow.
Loved it. Oh, I had so much fun on that map.
Oh, that's awesome.
However, Tuesday night was the time that I really had dedicated to play online with the new maps. I mean, everybody was anticipating it for that day, right? I was plagued with lag all night long. I was so disappointed. Most of my games, people had two bars. Like, most of the people would have two bars. I'd say 80% of the people would have about two bars, and some would have three.
That sucks.
Yeah. So it would just lag, and I would shoot somebody, like, headshot, and I'd take, like, four or five shots at their head, and nothing. And then some parts where the person, they'd be in front of me, but it'd, like, twitch left and right, like the server couldn't decide where the person actually was.
Oh, I gotcha.
Oh, my gosh. I was so frustrated. I'm like, you know, okay, maybe it's just these couple games. I left Team Deathmatch, and I joined Domination. Same problem. Not as bad in Domination, but I really wanted to play Team Deathmatch.
Sure.
So, yeah, I was very disappointed. But, I mean, I'm loving the maps. It's just that night, I guess, everybody was on.
Yeah. Now, I wonder if it's, like, the region, you know? I mean, the area where, I guess, those servers are just getting pounded, or if it's just totally across all the servers. I mean, that's...
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't look it up. I didn't want to fuel the frustration.
That's true.
And
that's like every developer or whatever's like one of their fears, you know, to roll out something brand new and it just gets bogged down. I mean, that sucks.
Yeah. I mean, they got to be prepared for the amount of users.
Sure.
But I mean, I was just so looking forward to it. And very first game, it's like my team spawns. And I'm like, I'm doing fine. As soon as I run into the opposition, the other team starts lagging and starts glitching like crazy, and I'm like, what the heck's going on? I thought I was going to get disconnected, but I didn't. And then people would quit, and understandably, and then it would migrate hosts, and then it would get worse, and it was like, oh my gosh. Yeah, I mean, I'm sure I'm not the only one.
Yeah.
But I did have a couple rounds where I'm quite sure the glitch, the lagging was in my favor, because I would shoot people, and they would just stand there. And it happened way too often during the game for me to think that maybe that person was using a, you know, an RC XD or something.
Oh, I gotcha.
So,
well, hopefully that gets better and you can just enjoy the maps.
It's been getting better.
Okay. Well, that's good.
So, I mean, I'm still loving the maps. I just wish that the first time playing it, it wasn't that frustrating.
Yeah.
Because it made me not want to play. It's like, eh, you know what? I should wait till off-peak hours to play. But, you know, that's not how it should be. But yeah, I'm really enjoying the maps. And like I said, I absolutely love Studio. That is my favorite map.
Awesome.
Yeah. So I'm very excited about that. And that's my whole week.
Sweet. All right. Well, I guess let's tackle some of the news. So first thing, we have our Dead Space 3 review up. So be sure to check that out. We'll have a link in the description. Of course, you can go to dayzerogamer.com and you should see that up at the highlights. Next is Nintendo's online store is now selling the 3DS XL Circle Pad Pro attachment for $19.99. So take a look in the description. We'll have a link to that as well. And speaking of Nintendo, they had a 3DS themed Nintendo Direct video this last week. So during it, we learned a few things. So I'll run down the list of the noteworthy bullet points, if you will. So Mario and Luigi, Dream Team for the 3DS, is going to arrive in stores August 11th. So that's good. Mario Party title will launch on the 3DS later this year, pretty much during winter. A new 2.5D Yoshi's Island title was announced. So that's pretty awesome. It's coming to the 3DS. The Legend of Zelda Oracle of Ages and Oracle of Seasons is going to be available on the 3DS eShop May 30th. So that's pretty sweet. And speaking of The Legend of Zelda, this actually was quite shocking. A brand new top-down title set within a Link to the Past world, so that universe, that's going to be released holiday 2013, so this year. And that's pretty intense because this isn't E3. I mean, this was just a random day. I mean, it's just Nintendo announced a brand new Legend of Zelda game, and that's exciting. Yes,
very exciting.
Let's see, Earthbound. That's going to be available on the Wii U Virtual Console later this year. So that is really, really great for, of course, fans of that game. And that game hasn't actually seen a release since the SNES. So finally, let's see. Shin Megami Tensei 4, that's going to arrive on the 3DS systems on July 16th. And there's going to be a first print run limited edition, of course, with all sorts of goodies. So that's awesome. Professor Layton.
Yay!
And the Azran Legacy, that's going to arrive in Europe this year. And in North America next year.
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of strange. Think about it. Europe and then us?
I know.
It's like, darn, why can't they both be at the same time? And Nintendo confirmed that Pikmin 3, that's going to launch on August 4th. So, yeah, that's exciting.
Oh, I loved Pikmin. That was fun.
Very, very fun. I can't wait to see that.
Mm-hmm.
Game & Wario for the Nintendo Wii U. That's going to be available June 23rd. And lastly, the Wii U is going to receive that spring update next week. So that's going to include improved load times, and it's going to actually add the Wii U Virtual Console to the system. So pretty cool. All in all, nice, definitely nice announcements. And we'll have a link to the Nintendo Direct video in the description.
Awesome.
And to wrap up the news, going back to Injustice, Lobo has been revealed as the first DLC character. So for those that have the season pass, that's the first one you're going to get. Otherwise, I believe he's going to be $5. So for those that are buying the characters separately, you have a choice to pick them up, and that'll be coming soon.
Cool.
And that is that. So let us go. Retro game status, Super Mario Bros. 3 for the NES.
Raccoon Tail.
Yes.
Okay, on top of being totally cute, I love being able to fly.
Oh, yeah. No, seriously.
Considering I always fall and miss jump or over jump. Flying is an awesome ability.
Yeah, it does help. It definitely helps. Being able to float, you know, keep tapping the button and you're like...
Yeah.
Very helpful.
It's my lifesaver.
Yeah, that was an awesome power-up. That leaf, fantastic. And speaking of power-ups, I mean, geez, there were quite a bit. There was like the frog suit. I don't know if you remember that. Better swim skills.
Oh, yeah, that was cute too.
Mm-hmm. The hammer suit. So you could throw those hammers like the Hammer Brothers. So that was awesome. Let's see. There was the... It was like the raccoon, but it's like when you're in the full body. Like, what was it called? The Tanuki suit? There you go.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so that was cool. You could turn into stone. So you're kind of like invincible. You just like planted there. And then there's that boot. You remember that? You can get into that giant boot.
Yeah.
It's like for that one level, but yeah, that was pretty cool. It's like strange, like weird, but yeah. It was pretty neat because this game, those power-ups, I think for me as a kid especially, because I mean I played it first when I was a kid, that was like what hooked me. Because I mean I loved Mario, but getting these different suits, it was like, that is so cool.
Yes.
Because you don't just have the fire, you don't just have the mushroom, the star, but now you actually get these crazy suits and it changes the way he looks. I mean, you actually look like a frog. Well, I mean Mario-faced frog, I guess, but yeah, pretty awesome.
Yeah, I never quite understood the leaf. And then getting the raccoon tail to fly. That I mean, like, the leaf goes with the raccoon because raccoons climb trees. Well, they climb everything. They go through your garbage.
Climb the garbage cans.
But yeah, you know, I never quite understood the connection.
I'm sure there is one, but yeah, truthfully, I don't know what it is either.
Yeah. Anyway, sidetrack. But the boot, yeah, that was interesting. You ever see the video by Mega 64?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, we got to put a link to that in the description.
Oh, that is right.
If you haven't seen it, you got to watch it.
Those guys are awesome.
Oh, my goodness. But yeah, it's sadly enough, when you mentioned the boot, that was the first thing I thought of.
Well, hey, that's real life versus a video game, so.
Oh, I really like the Koopalings.
Oh, of course.
Mini bosses.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they were kind of cute.
Yeah, I guess so. I just wanted to smash them.
I guess if I had one word for this game, it's cute. It's cute. Probably not exactly what they were going for, but
I can see that. You know what I like, though, is the world map. Because instead of just going level after level after level, I mean, now you can see the map and you can actually kind of go your own direction. You know, there's different paths.
That's right.
So that was cool.
Yeah. And
also, I mean, this was the first time Mario could pick up shells. I mean, you could do it, I guess, in Mario 2. But if you're not going to count Super Mario 2, then, I mean, this is the first traditional Mario game where you can jump on a turtle and you can pick him up.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can also slide down the hills. If you push down, you can like slide on it.
Oh, yeah. I love doing that.
Awesome. That I think that was like cute. The second level. This is cute. What? Maybe. All right.
Oh, and at the end of the stages, the cards.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That's right. Yeah, those are cute, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Honestly, that's pretty much all I gotta say. If everything's gonna be cute, you know, I mean, hey, Luigi's in it. That's cute.
You're like, okay, Linda keeps saying cute. I'm gonna stop talking completely. No, it was a very, very fun Mario.
Yeah, I love Mario 1, 2. I mean, those were great, but Part 3 was like my absolute favorite.
Cool.
I like them a lot.
You know, going back to the suit thing, I really like that they were suits. You didn't just turn into a frog.
That's true, yeah.
It's like you're wearing a suit
mm-hmm.
to show the ability you have instead of just turning into it. I think that's very cool. I like that.
Instead of turning into a frog with like a big mustache. He'd be cute though, right?
Yeah, or growing wings out of nowhere or something.
Yeah, like, yeah, that would be kind of weird.
Yeah.
Yeah, except, I guess, the raccoon tail, the leaf, though. I mean, he sprouted a tail and ears. Unless he somehow changed pants and changed his hat.
Yeah.
So, it is possible.
You know, kind of like the Halloween costume for girls, the cat and the...
That's true. Yeah, that's
very possible. The tail.
I wonder how that helps him fly, but...
I don't get it either. Yeah. That goes back to the raccoon,
mm-hmm,
the
back
leaf,
to the beginning.
Flying.
Yeah. I guess it doesn't really matter because he was cool doing it.
Yeah.
Flying is
off. Save my life, then. I'm not going to complain.
Same here.
Is it weird that every time I think of Mario flying, I want to wiggle my tail, even though I don't have one?
What? Well, alrighty then.
Yeah, I think I'm trailing now. I'm done.
Dang. All right. Well, I guess we'll go ahead and say we wanted to thank everyone that took the time to listen to the show. Be on the lookout next Sunday for show number 76. Special thanks to Ronald Jenkins for providing disorganized fun for the Infinite Live Show theme song.
Have a cute week.
Bye.